Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 2013. Get pivot data may not be entirely evil. I'll be podcasting this entire book. Click that I in the top right hand corner to subscribe. All right, back in episode 1998, I talked briefly about this get pivot data problem. If we calculate a percentage variance and we're outside of the pivot table pointing inside, and I use the mouse or the arrow key, so 2019 divided by 2018 minus 1, this answer that we're going to get here is correct for January. But when we double click to copy that down, the formula does not copy. We get the January answer all the way down, and when we look at it, we're getting get pivot data. I didn't type get pivot data. I just pointed to those cells, and this started happening back in Excel 2002 without any warning whatsoever. And at that point, I said the way to avoid this is to type the formula C5 divided by B5 minus 1, and you'll get a formula that you can copy. Or if you just hate get pivot data, if it's completely evil, go to the Analyze tab. Don't open the Options button. By the way, go back to the pivot table. Go to the Analyze tab. Open the drop down next to Options, uncheck this box. It's a global setting. Once you turn it off, it'll be off forever. All right. Most of the time, the questions I get are, how do I turn get pivot data off? But every once in a while, I will get someone who loves get pivot data. And I was having lunch with Rob Colley when he was still at Microsoft, and he said, well, our internal customers love get pivot data. And I said, what? No, everyone hates get pivot data. He says, Rob says, you're right. Outside of Microsoft, absolutely. They hate get pivot data. I'm talking about the accountants inside of Microsoft. And later, I met one who now works for the Excel team, Carlos. And Carlos was one of the accountants who used this method. All right, so here's what we have to do. We have a report, a data set here, that for every month we have the plan for each store. And then at the bottom, we are accumulating actuals. All right, so we have actuals for January through December, but we only have actuals for a few months, the months that have gone past. And what our manager wants us to do is build a report with stores down the left-hand side, only the Texas stores, of course, to make life more difficult. And then going across, we have months. And if we have an actual for that month, we show the actual. So January actual, February actual, March actual, April actual. But then for the months where we don't have actuals, we switch over and show the budget. So budget out through December, and then a total, totaling everything. All right, well, when you try and create this pivot table, yeah, it doesn't work. So insert pivot table, new worksheet. You put store down the left-hand side, that's beautiful. Put months across the top, put type across the top, put sales here. All right, so here's what we get that we have to start to work with. So we have January actual, January plan, and then the completely useless January actual plus plan. No one will ever use this. But I can get rid of these gray columns, that's easy enough. Come here to this cell, go to field settings, and change the subtotals to none. But there's absolutely no way for me to remove the January plan that won't also remove the April, May, June, July plan, right? There's no way to get rid of this. So at this point, every month, I'm stuck selecting the entire pivot table, going to copy, and then paste values. It's not a pivot table anymore, and then I start manually deleting the columns that don't appear in the report. All right, that's the normal method. But the accountants at Microsoft have added an extra step in January. It takes, you know, 15 minutes, and that step allows this pivot table to live forever, right? I call this the world's ugliest pivot table, and the accountants at Microsoft accept that this is the world's ugliest pivot table, but no one will ever see this report except for them. What they do is they come here to a new sheet and build the report that their manager wants. All right, so here's the stores down the left-hand side. I even grouped it into Houston, Dallas, and other. It's a nicely formatted report. I've highlighted the totals. You'll see that when we get some numbers in, there's currency on the first row, but not the subsequent rows. Blank rows, blank rows in a pivot table. And one tiny bit of logic up here where I can put the through date in cell P1, and then I have a formula here that analyzes that. If the month of the through date is greater than this column, then put the word actual, otherwise put the word plan, right? So all I have to do is change this through date, and then the word actual flip over to plan. All right, now here's what we do. We're going to allow ourselves to be get pivot data'd, right? I'm not sure that that's a verb, but we're going to allow Microsoft to get pivot data. So I start building a formula with an equal sign. I grab the mouse and I'm going to go look for January actual Baybrook. So I go back into the world's ugliest pivot table. I find Baybrook, I find January, I find actual, and I click enter and let them do it to me. All right, there we go. We now have a get pivot data formula. I remember the day that I did this, it was like, you know, after Rob explained to me what they were doing and I went back and tried it. Now all of a sudden, all my life I've been getting rid of get pivot data. I've never actually embraced get pivot data. So what it is the first item is what we're looking for. There's a field called sales. This is where the pivot table lives. It starts, and it can be any cell in the pivot table. They use the top left hand. All right, this is a field named store, and then they've hard-coded Baybrook. This is a field named month. They've hard-coded January. This is a field named type, and they've hard-coded actual. That's why you can't copy it, because they've hard-coded the values. But the accountants at Microsoft, Carlos and his coworkers, realize, well, wait a second. We have the word Baybrook here. We have January here, we have actual here. We just need to change this formula to point to the actual cells in the report instead of being hard-coded. All right, so they call this parameterizing the get pivot data. Remove the word Baybrook, come over here and click on cell D6. Now, I need to lock this down to the column. All right, so I press the F4 key three times. One, two, three times. Get a single dollar sign before the D. All right, for the month of January, I remove the hard-coded January. I click on this cell, E3, and I'll press F4 twice to lock it down to the row, $3. Type actual. Remove the word actual, click on E4, again, F4 twice. All right, and I get a formula that now pulls that data back. I'm going to copy that, and then paste special, choose formulas, Alt-ESF. See, the F is underlined there. ESF, enter. And then now that I've done that, I'll just repeat with F4. F4 is a redo. And F4. All right. So now we have a nice looking report. It has blanks. It has formatting. It has the single accounting underline under each section. At the very bottom, it has the double accounting underline, right? You never get this stuff in a pivot table. It's impossible. But this report is driven from the pivot table. So then what we do when we get the May actuals, come back here, paste them in, go refresh the world's ugliest pivot table, and then here on the report, just change the through date from 430 to 531. And what that does is that causes this formula to switch over from the word plan to actual, which goes and pulls the actuals from the report instead of the plan. All right, now, here's the thing, that this is a great, right? I can see where I would do this a lot if I still, you know, worked in accounting. The thing you have to be really careful about is if they build a new store, you have to know to add it in manually, right? The data is going to show up in the pivot table, but you would add it in manually. Now, this one is a subset of all the stores. If it was reporting all the stores, I would probably out here outside of the print range have something that pulled the grand total from the pivot table, and then I would know if this total doesn't match the grand total from the pivot table, that something's wrong. I'd have an if function down here saying, hey, there's, you know, new data that's been added. Be very careful to have some sort of a mechanism to detect that new data is there. But I get it. It's a cool use. So while most of the time get pivot data just drives us crazy, there can actually be a use for it. All right, so that's tip number 21 out of 40 in the book. You can buy the book right now, order online, click that I in the top right-hand corner. Long, long recap today. All right, get pivot data happens when a formula points inside of a pivot table. A formula outside the pivot table points inside. While the initial formula is correct, it won't copy. Most people hate get pivot data and want to prevent it. So you can build a formula without the mouse or the arrow keys. Just type the formula or turn off get pivot data permanently. But there's a use. All right, so we had to build a report with actuals for past month, budget for future, normal workflow, create a pivot table, convert to values, delete columns. There is a way to remove the subtotals by using field settings, getting rid of that January actual plus plan. Instead, we're just going to create the world's ugliest pivot table with too much data, build a nicely formatted, just plain old report worksheet with maybe a little bit of logic to change the word actual to plan. And then from the first report cell, the first place where numbers are going to be in that report, type an equal sign, go point to the pivot table, and allow get pivot data to happen. we examine the syntax of getPivotData. So it's the field to return sales, where the pivot table lives, and then pairs of criteria, the field name and the value. We're going to remove the value, the hard-coded value, and point to a cell. Pressing F4 three times locks only the column. Pressing F4 two times locks to only the row. Copy that formula, paste special formulas. I threw in an extra tip there that F4 is a redo. So I only had to go to the paste special dialog once, and then for the next two paste specials, paste special formulas just used F4. Next month, add the data, refresh the pivot table, change the through date, make sure they didn't build any new stores, have some sort of a mechanism, either manual or a check formula. Check it out. Thanks to iTrainerMX on Twitter who suggested getPivotData. Also Carlos and Rob from Microsoft, Rob now from Power Pivot Pro, Carlos for using this, and Rob for telling me that Carlos was using it. I met Carlos later, and he confirms, yes, he was one of the accountants who used this all the time at Microsoft. All right, there you go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.